Hey everyone, this is White Armor, and today I'm going to show you how to install and use KeePass. KeePass is a password vault that allows you to manage all your passwords from a single master password. By default, it does not have online access and stores strictly to your device only. Let's begin. First, open up a browser and type in KeePass. Look for keepass.info and click the first link. Then you're going to click the first released link, which in this case is 2.39. Then click download KeePass. And here you're going to get two versions. The one we're going to be focused on is 2.39. If you want to see a comparison table to know what components are different, you can click this link and it'll show you the different options. Because we want all the options, we're going to stick with 2.39. So go ahead and download now. If you want to know what OSs it will install to, that is also below. The one we're focusing on today is Windows 10 installation. So when you're ready, click download now. From here, we'll just wait till it finishes downloading. We'll then save it under downloads or wherever you like. When it's finished, go to the folder. Double click, you will then get a pop-up that looks like this, and we can close the browser. Click OK for English or whichever language you prefer. You will then get a second window, which is the user agreement. Read through it and click I accept the agreement. Next, make sure it says full installation. All the options are checked on and click next. Make sure you create a desktop shortcut so it's ease of use later on. And make sure that associate KeePass with the KDBX file extension is checked on as well. Click next and then click install. Now I already have it installed, so I'm going to cancel out of this. Yours will look like this. No database, no entries, and now we're going to start. So first go to file, click new. You're going to create your very first database, which is going to hold all the usernames and passwords associated with each website. Click OK. From here, you're going to name your database, save it anywhere you like on your PC, or the best option is to save it into a backup solution or a USB key as well. For now, we're going to save it to desktop for testing purposes and click save. Here, you're going to create a master password, which is what is used to open up KeePass to access all your passwords. So make sure this is long and complex. For this example, I'm going to use a known password to make it easier. There's also more advanced options. One of them is called the key file. When you create a key file, this is going to allow you to create a key that has to be used with your master password to access the database. Now this key file can be put onto a USB key or a backup solution, and whenever you need to access your database, you need that key along with the master password. You can also use your Windows user account. My advice is not to use that one. For this example, we're just going to do master password to make things easy. Click OK. Then you're going to have the database options. Here you can give it a short description of whatever you like, what the database is for. You can also then call your database whatever you like as well. Security, leave it as the defaults. Compression, leave it as the defaults. Make sure recycle bin is checked on. And advanced, leave it as defaults and click OK. Here you can print an emergency sheet where you can write down your master password and all the options that you had just previously selected. And then you can put it into a safe or keep it somewhere in your desk. For now, I'm just going to click skip because we're not going to do that. Now you're going to see KeePass, and you're going to have two entries that are examples, and you're going to have subfolders that are underneath your new database. Here, if you want to create new subfolders for yourself, you can delete the ones that are here by right-clicking and saying delete group, or you can go under database, right-click and say add group, and you can be specific. You can call them whatever you like to make it more meaningful. In this case, I'll call it social media. Here, if I start adding entries, I'm going to right click, add entry, and anything under social media will be the entries that I'm adding in. So for now, I'm going to do Facebook as a test. The title is the name or title that is going to be describing the website that you're trying to log into and save the data. So for this one, it's going to be Facebook. The username will be whitearmor@facebook.com, which will be the username, which doesn't exist. This is just for an example. The password will be whatever the password is required for Facebook login. And then the URL, you're going to open up a browser, go to Facebook, either through the URL directly or Google, type in Facebook, look for log on to Facebook or log on or Facebook login, click it, and where you see username, email or phone or password sections, that's where you want to copy that URL. Click it and Control C, copy it, go back to KeePass, under URL, you're going to Control V and paste. Here you can add a note, just to give you an idea of what this is for, and then click OK to add your entry. Now, when you want to use this for logging in, because all you're going to need to remember is your master password, what you do is you double click underneath password. You're going to see a bar appear and you have 12 seconds to use the password. Go to your URL and Control V to paste the password. Then go back to KeePass, double click the username, go back to the website, Control V, and the username is pasted. Then you click login and you're all done. If you want to access their perform auto type feature, what you do is you go to the website that you want to log into. Make sure your cursor is underneath the email login section. Go back to KeePass, right click the entry, perform auto type. Now, because this isn't a real username and password, it's not going to go anywhere, but you get the point. Go back to KeePass and start adding in new entries. You put the password to your Twitter account, the URL, same thing, look for Twitter, login. Make sure you see username, email, password sections. Grab that URL, paste it, add a note, and click OK. And that's it. That's how you add entries into KeePass. That's how you will save your usernames and passwords. Now, if you want to change a password on a particular account and you just don't quite understand or just don't quite know what password to use, what you can do is you can right click, edit entry, and where the three dots are, underneath it, you'll see generate a password. Now here, you click it, you open password generator, and here you have all the options to make a very complex, long password. You can select the options you like, you can change the character length. And then when you're all done, if you click OK, you'll notice the very long password is generated. If you click the three dots, it will show you exactly what that password looks like. You can Control C, go back to the website. When you're logged in, you can say, I want to change my password. And then you can paste your new password into the account section and save that password. When you're all done, you click OK. And that new password that you saved on your account and in KeePass are now saved. So next time when you go to log on to Twitter or whichever website you're trying to log on to, you have just generated a very long, complex password, and that one will then be saved and you can use it on your new site, permitted that you changed it on the site as well. When you're all done, make sure that you click Save. And for a bonus feature to make sure that you do things and make it more automated, go to Tools, Options, under Advanced, make sure you check off Automatically Save when closing or locking the database. That way, when you close or lock the database, it will automatically save the database. Click OK. When you want to lock the database, go to File, and then click Lock Workspace. You can also click the icon right here that looks like a little lock. Click that. and then your database will show an icon that looks has a little red line through it. That means that it's locked and no one can access it while you're away from the computer. When you click it, it will ask you for your master password, and only that will let you get in. And that's pretty much all there is to it. You can create new folders, add multiple accounts. You can add your Gmail, your social media accounts. You can add specific entries that even don't relate to URLs or other websites. You can, if it's a password that's for your phone or for something specific, you can just come in and title it whatever you want it to be. Doesn't have to have a username. You can just paste your password and you can click save, and the entry will save there. Just make sure that you fill out the notes to describe what it is so that way you don't forget, and hit save. That's generally about it. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions about KeePass or want more examples, please let me know in the comments below. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and consider subscribing for future videos. Thanks, and take care.